Hi, my name is Diana Wilson. I'm with DEVCO Public Schools, and I'm here with your Now Boarding Report. This is basically an overview of what our five-member board does here for DEVCO Public Schools. We're pretty big. We have 155 schools and 85,000 students, so our all-volunteer elected board has some big decisions to make. In January, the Board of Education heard about facilities planning. The baseline is if DEVCO strategically modernizes and maintains facilities, then student learning environments will improve. So our facilities department is really looking at what our structures offer students to improve their learning. The board heard about those plans. We had a big bond pass in November, so there'll be a lot of funding invested in our facilities. So really trying to figure out our philosophy behind how we spend those dollars based on education is an important thing to look at. The board also approved several charters. These were renewals, schools that have been here before, and they need to do that on an annual basis. They heard about healthy and nutritious meals. So looking at our school breakfast and lunch, what we offer now, how we hope to improve it, how do we hope to get our kids to eat healthier and a lot more fresh foods and what it would take to get where we want to be. Another issue the board heard about was programming at Jefferson Junior Senior High School, as well as what we might do with the school site we have at 20th and Hoyt. Basically trying to plan ahead for what the community needs and different programming needs that we have in DEVCO. Jefferson Junior Senior High is slated for some big improvements in their facilities, so trying to make some programming choices before all that construction happens is beneficial. The board directed staff to run a survey about 5A funding priorities. Again, one of the funding measures that passed in November, thank you voters, is funding for a variety of different operational investments. It was specified in the ballot language the topics that this money would be spent on, but now we need to prioritize so we know how to break up those dollars. STEM, early childhood education, mental health supports, career tech ed, and the different types of things we can do in those areas, really trying to find out what the community feels is the most important so as the board develops the budget, they can spend it the way our community would like to see it spent. The board heard some great news from the Colorado Department of Education in January. Our graduation rates are up, our completion rates are up, and our dropout rate is down. For DEVCO Public Schools, we've had a five-year trend of our graduation rate increasing. Completion, which means kids that finish up school after the four-year on-time graduation, those rates are up as well. So to see those improvements over the last 5 years, it's very exciting, making sure that we're moving in the right direction. In February, our board will hear from a number of task forces. Dr. Glass, our superintendent, brought together citizens, community members, business members, staff, students to work on a variety of different issues facing the district. One of those was start times at schools. So what time does middle school start? What time does high school start? How does that affect our students? How does that affect learning? So this task force met for about the last year and is bringing recommendations to the board. Another task force was community engagement. They put together some feedback also to present to the board. So basically the board's going to take this information from these groups that really spent a lot of time looking at the issues, seeing what research says and seeing what other school districts are doing and see what can be implemented here in DEVCO, what makes sense for us and what we have the resources to support. February is the time we start looking at the budget seriously, our 2019-20 school year budget. We don't hear from the state officially until May, but they do put out preliminary budget estimates so that the school districts can get started on their budget planning. Another big celebration in February is the Colorado Department of Education Awards. 38 DEVCO Public Schools earned 44 academic awards from the CDE. These are based on the 2017-18 Colorado Measures of Academic Success, so that's basically standardized testing. Last year we had 35 schools earn awards, so we bumped up to 38 this year, so very excited about that. Thanks for tuning in to Now Boarding. I'll see you again next month.